On today's episode of NBA Kicks, we have an unreleased pair of Kobe 5s, another debut of a brand new signature sneaker, and we find out what Kawhi Leonard's favorite candy is. I'm your host, Jerron Mott. Welcome to NBA Kicks. Starting off the list at number 10, we have Semi Ojeleye with the gold colorway of the Nike Air Foamposite Pro. Now, Semi Ojeleye is a pretty big guy, so it would make sense that he would want to play in a sneaker that is known for being extra supportive. And if you've ever played in a pair of Foamposites, you would know that these are pretty tough to break in. Nonetheless, the Air Foamposite Pro is a classic, and it's always good to see it on the court, especially in this killer metallic gold colorway, which released back in 2017 and would go perfect with the Celtic City Edition uniforms, but for whatever reason, Boston isn't wearing them in the postseason. I guess once you see BossCon, you can never unsee it. Next up at number 7, we have Montrezl Harrell with another colorway of the Reebok Question. Now, Montrezl rocking a pair of Questions is nothing new, but I'm a 90s baby, so this silhouette, it holds a special place in my heart. And you also gotta give props to Montrezl for adding a little bit of his own personal style to this colorway. On its own, this colorway is already pretty dope with a black leather upper that is complemented with a red patent leather mudguard, which goes right into a red midsole, but the splash of green is a very nice touch that kind of gives these a Grinch type of vibe and also just adds some more personality to this colorway overall. Coming in at number 8, we have Jamal Murray with the bread colorway of the Adi Zero Rose 1.0. So the 1.0s are a cool sneaker. However, I am more partial to its semi-successor, the 1.5s, because not only do I think it's a cleaner looking silhouette, but who could forget that awesome commercial where Rose was spinning that shoe? I don't know how he did that. Murray's Black and Red Rose 1.0s are a nice little blast from the past, and it's pretty cool to see Adidas retroing Rose's signature line, even though their on-court performance is a little dated with a narrow fit and aged materials, but at the end of the day, they still look clean on the court and still have a very unique design with an ankle brace style collar, which honestly is something that we don't see a lot of on the market today. But for real, if you guys could spin a shoe on your finger like Rose can, make sure you at me on Instagram and I will definitely repost it because I want to see that. Next up at number 7, we have Taylor Horton Tucker with the Prelude Nike Kobe 7s. So Taylor Horton Tucker has gotten some run for the Lakers in their series against the Rockets. And while his play on the court has been solid, the shoe game has definitely outshined his hoop game. THT brings out the Prelude colorway of the Kobe 7s, which was a standout colorway from the entire pack. And even though the 7s were extremely disappointing on the court performance-wise, aesthetically, the 7s are still one of the best-looking Kobes of all time. And they also have some of the best colorways from the entire Kobe Bryant signature line, and these Preludes are no exception. I do think the Lakers should only wear the Mamba jerseys from here on out because seriously, they don't lose when they wear those jerseys.
That's true. That's very true.
Next up at number 6, we have Kawhi Leonard with the special collab of the Kawhi from New Balance. All right, so last week we saw Kawhi with a pretty basic black and silver colorway, which was definitely on brand. However, New Balance hooks Kawhi up this week with a Jolly Rancher colorway because I guess Kawhi really likes Jolly Ranchers. This colorway uses a white base that is accented with an array of colors for a rainbow-like effect, but if you take a close look at the tongue, you can see that New Balance put a special edition graphic with a Jolly Rancher-inspired logo, except that all of the fruit have a deadpan expression to match Kawhi's stoic personality. Now these are part of a collection which include the alternate blue colorway of the Kawhi, as well as special edition colorways of the 326, 480 low, as well as a pair of slides, which are all slated to release sometime in October. So if you're a Jolly Rancher fan or just a fan of Kawhi, be on the lookout for this release, especially since the Kawhi has been one of the tougher shoes to get your hands on this season. All right, so usually before we get to our top 5, we go over some honorable mentions. However, since more teams are being eliminated from the playoffs, there are less sneakers being worn on the court. So I don't have honorable mentions for you on today's episode, but now would be the perfect time to drop a like on this video, because not only does it just take a second, but it really, really helps me out. So please, guys, I would really appreciate it if you drop a like, or if you're pissed off, just drop a dislike. It really doesn't matter. Just hit one of the thumbs and I'll be happy. Kicking off our top five sneakers of the week, we have Lou Williams with the Peak Tai Chi Flash 2.0. Okay, so I'll admit that I'm not 100% sure what these sneakers are called officially, but I did do some research, and I think these are the Tai Chi 2.0s from Peak, which is a China-based sportswear brand that has made some solid on-court performers throughout the years. However, here we see Lou Will with a black and white colorway, which is accented with some bright greens and reds, which adds a nice little splash of color. All in all, there's not a whole lot going on here, but there is a special cartoon graphic on the lateral side of the collar, which does add some more personality to the silhouette. But at the end of the day, it's just a straight up clean looking sneaker that is at its best in this simple black and white colorway. Let me know if you guys would rock these in the comment section below. Next up at number four, we have Jayson Tatum with another Taco PE of the Air Jordan 34. All right, so JT wore two Taco PEs of my beloved Jordan 34s, one in an orange colorway and one in a purple colorway. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I think that the orange pair is the better of the two, since it gives us more taco vibes than the purple ones. I mean, just look at them. From a distance, they actually look like a taco with that color scheme, especially with those lettuce style cutouts on the collar area, which honestly is hilarious. And even though I'm not sure what tacos and Jayson Tatum have to do with each other, I'm really glad that Jordan Brand has killed it with the PEs of the 34s and is continuing to hook JT up with some great player exclusives. Next up at number three, we have PJ Tucker with an unreleased colorway of the Nike Kobe 5. So if you've been watching the sneaker show, you would already know that PJ Tucker has his own colorway of the Kobe Pro Tro dropping on September 25th, which also happens to be my birthday. But PJ also rocked an unreleased pair of the Kobe 5 Pro Tro that we have never seen before. Now, while it's unclear where or when this colorway came from, I think it's safe to say that these are a new colorway of the Pro Tros, since the upper looks very similar to that alternate Bruce Lee colorway that is supposed to be dropping in the near future. But with these, we get some hot pink accents instead, which works very well with the black and white upper. Either way, I think it's safe to say that if Nike does plan to drop these in the future, they will most definitely do well on retail shelves, especially if you give them some KOW branding, but we'll just have to wait and see if these will ever find a retail drop. But for real though, PJ Tucker's plug needs to chill, because he's just pulling out all these Kobes that we have never seen before, and it's making Kobe fans like myself really jealous. Coming in as our runner up, we have Russell Westbrook with the Jordan Why Not 0.3 SE. Russell Westbrook breaks out the wear test colorway of the SE version of his third signature model, which uses a white upper that is littered with a wear test graphic, as well as some bright crimson hints, which add some much needed color. Now, we've seen the wear test colorways from Jordan Brand earlier this season, but this colorway is just too good to pass up. And for my money, these are the best Why Not 0.3s that Jordan Brand has put out. And honestly, I have no idea why Jordan Brand has not dropped these on retail shelves. I know you might not be selling a bunch of Westbrooks out there in the stores, Jordan Brand, but honestly, if you drop more dope colorways like these instead of the boring ones that you have been releasing, more people would buy them. I know I would. Finally, at number one, we have PJ Tucker and Jeff Green with the debut of the Air Jordan 35. Now again, if you've been watching the sneaker show, we already talked about the Jordan 35. And while I am excited for its eventual release, I do have some concerns about them performance-wise. Now, as for the shoe visually, I actually think it's a decent looking silhouette, even though I'm not a huge fan of this colorway in particular. But the fact that these are inspired by one of my favorite J's of all time, the Air Jordan 5, that's enough for me to cop a pair for myself. Now, as you can see, Jordan Brand continues to use that Eclipse Plate technology on the midfoot, which makes me very happy since the 34s have been my go-to on-court sneaker since they released. So hopefully Jordan Brand can continue to provide top-tier performance with the 35s. But for now, all we can do is debate whether or not the 35s are a cop or a drop. So let me know what you guys think about these in the comments section below. You guys already know that I am absolutely going to cop these on day one because the Jordan 34 was just an incredible sneaker. So I have to see what these are about, but let me know what you guys think about them in the comment section below. I would love to hear what you have to say about them. And if you haven't already, drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel for more episodes of NBA Kicks just like this. My name is Jaren. It's been good having you. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.